A convicted sex offender at the center of a zoning controversy in Port Orange is speaking out. His comments to the council and people in the audience caused several disruptions, and the new ordinance restricting where sex offenders can live passed easily. WESH 2 Stuart Moore attended that meeting, and Stuart, that ordinance passed, but the fight for many is not over.
That's right, Martha. A lot of people here vowing that they will continue this fight, whether or not going through the school board or through the state. In the meanwhile, Howard Porter, the man who was actually the convicted sex offender who lives across from the school, he and parents took to the podium and squared off against each other.
People here that call you a predator, what do you say to them?
Predator? I'm not after any kids.
Howard Porter left City Hall knowing the decision to restrict where sex offenders can live in Port Orange does not affect him one bit. He says he understands why parents are concerned, but says he's not in any hurry to leave.
If anybody touched my daughter, I'd feel the same way. But adding more restrictions is not going to help the problem.
Porter was convicted in 2004 for soliciting sex with a child and possession of child porn. He says he only moved to his parents' Port Orange home because he had nowhere else to go. For parents, it's an emotional move that has them outraged.
My greatest fear is that one of my nieces or nephews, my child, another child at Sugar Mill, she's been there for 6 years, that he's going to hurt one of the children there. And I can't stand to see that happen.
Maybe we could put some barricades up. I know we can't force him to move, but maybe we could put some barricades up so he can't see those children as they're playing on the playground.
While the new restrictions will force sex offenders convicted after 2004 to stay away from schools and churches, it still does not go as far as keeping them from bus stops or walking past the school. A Porter will stay for now. These parents say they will continue fighting until he's gone.
Some parents here are going to be banding together to see if we can't go to the school district as well and see what we can't do.
Now, parents say that they will be writing letters to lawmakers in Tallahassee asking for the ability to be able to tell people who are grandfathered in as sex offenders to not be able to live that close to school districts. In the meantime, Porter says that he will be back here at the next city council meeting. Reporting live in Port Orange, Stuart Moore, WESH 2 News on TW18.